Some important concepts under citizenship. Paul Manzares versus Comelec. Foundlings are natural-born citizens. Bingson III versus Atret 2001 case. There are only two types of citizens. First, natural-born citizens, those citizens of Philippines from birth without having to perform any act to acquire or perfect his Philippine citizenship. Second, naturalized citizens, those who have become Filipino citizens through naturalization. Some important concepts under law and public officers. Navarro versus CA 2001 case. In cases of vacancy in the Sanggunian, the successor to be appointed must be from the political party of the one who caused the last vacancy. The last vacancy in the Sanggunian refers to that created by the elevation of the member formerly occupying the next higher in rank, which in turn also had become vacant. Castro versus JBC 2010 case, prohibition on midnight appointment under Section 15, Article 7 does not apply to appointments to fill vacancy in the Supreme Court or to other appointments to judiciary. Midnight appointment is made by the President or Acting President within 2 months immediately before the next presidential election. Grounds for impeachment, culpable violation of the Constitution, treason, bribery, graft and corruption, other high crimes, betrayal of public trust. Carpio Morales versus CA and Binay, condonation doctrine has been abandoned. Election is not a mode of condoning an administrative offense done during a prior term. Office of Ombudsman versus Vergara 2017 case. Condonation doctrine is still applicable in cases that transpired prior to the Carpio Morales versus CA and Binay ruling on November 10, 2015. The abandonment was prospective in application. Carpio Morales versus CA 2015 case, suspension as preventive measure versus suspension as penalty. Preventive suspension is merely a preliminary step in an administrative investigation, the purpose of which is to prevent the officer from using his office to influence potential witnesses or tamper with records which may be vital in the prosecution of the case against him. Suspension as penalty, if after preventive suspension or investigation, the charge is established and the person investigated is found guilty, then he may be suspended. This suspension is now imposed as penalty. Some important concepts under election law. Kabataan Partilis versus Comelec 2015 case. Biometric validation is not an additional qualification to the exercise of the right to suffrage, but a mere aspect of registration procedure of which the state has the right to reasonably regulate. Makalintal versus Comelec 2003 case. Overseas absentee voting is constitutional. General rule, a person must be physically present in the polling place where he is registered voter to be able to vote. Exception, absentee voting and detainee voting. Nuisance candidate is one who puts the election process in mockery or dispute, who causes confusion on similarity of names, and clearly demonstrates no bona fide intention to run. Effect of filing of COC of incumbent appointive officials. Appointive officials, including members of the AFP and officers of the government-owned or controlled corporations, shall be considered ipso facto resigned upon the filing of his certificate of candidacy. Effect of filing of COC of incumbent elective officials. Elective official may run for another position without forfeiting his seat. Hence, he is not deemed resigned upon the filing of his COC. Note, Comelec has ministerial duty to receive and acknowledge receipt of certificates of candidacy. Comelec en banc is not a tribunal of first instance. Any decision by the Commission en banc as regards election cases decided by it in the first instance is null and void. Halos Hos versus Comelec 2012 case. When may a second placer not be proclaimed as winner? Second placer cannot be proclaimed the winner if the first placer is disqualified in such a manner that the COC of the first placer was valid at the time of the filing but subsequently had to be cancelled because of a violation of law that took effect or a legal impediment that took effect after the filing of the COC. Some important concepts under local government. Navarro versus Armita, 2011 case, land area is not a requisite indicator of viability in creation of barangays. However, with respect to the creation of municipalities, component cities, provinces, the three indicators of viability and projected capacity to provide services are necessary requisites. The prohibition on midnight appointments applies only to presidential appointments. There is no law that prohibits local elective officials from making appointments during the last days of his or her tenure. Requisites of three-term limit rule. The following must concur. First, that the official concerned has been elected for three consecutive terms in same local government post. And second, that he has fully served the three consecutive terms. Important concept under education, academic freedom, for essential freedoms of a university to wit, who may teach, what may be taught, how it shall be taught, who may be admitted to study. Some important concepts under public international law. Obligations erga omnes. Obligations toward all are obligations which, by virtue of their nature and importance, are the concern of all states and for whose protection all states have legal interest. Bayan Muna versus Romulo, 2011 case. Jus cogens norms, means compelling law, are deemed peremptory and non-derogable norms. When applied to international crimes, jus cogens crimes have been deemed so fundamental to the existence of just international legal order that states cannot derogate from them even by agreement. Ex aequo et bono literally means according to right and good or from equity and good conscience are judgments based on considerations of fairness and not of existing law. International Court of Justice may only decide a case ex aequo et bono when parties agree to. Elements of customary international law. State practice, uniformity of practice among substantial number of states. Opinion iuris, the belief that the practice is rendered obligatory by the existence of a rule requiring it. Extradition, the removal of an accused from the requested state with the objective of placing him at the disposal of foreign authorities to enable the requesting state or government to hold him in connection with any criminal investigation directed against him or the execution of a penalty imposed on him under the penal or criminal law of the requesting state or government. Double criminality. Under this doctrine, the subject offense of the extradition must be punishable in the jurisdictions of both the requested and requesting parties. Government of Hong Kong versus Munoz, 2016 case. Extradition was not granted because the crime was accepting an advantage as an agent, and it has no equivalent crime in our jurisdiction. That's all. Thank you for watching. Comment down below if you have any suggestions for my next video. Also, check the description below, and to show your support, please click the subscribe button. And please follow my other social media accounts.